Fine, I'm gonna just talk normal. Not talk about this nuclear thing anymore. I'm just tired of it. I think you'll make your decisions. Do your own search and look and find out. Yeah, I need to talk other things. I want to talk today about matter in the room. I need to talk about energy and its displacements right here and right now in this chaotic jungle of house. The own place. I have a problem here, specific. I'll share. It's like with my shoes. I have special shoes that I wear for the dance, and when I wear the special shoes for the dance, they're very important. I have to have them. Now, if I put the shoes in a certain spot in the house, different from the day that I was dancing, there's always a chance that I'm not dance the next day, or not dance the day after that, or several days after. So there becomes a danger of this locality, the locality of the place of the object. So it is odd, isn't it? You take the dancing shoes situation, and we call the red shoes, and she danced and went off to train there. Well, in this situation, she never took her shoes off in that situation. But with this one, you have your shoes, and there is no way. There is no way. I can't put them on cardboard. There's never a way. I put them on cardboard for a moment, and there is such the fear, such the encapsulating fear of that phenomenon of cardboard at all. Those shoes being on cardboard, it's such a limiter. So I had to upgrade them. I have to upgrade them, and I have to put them over there on this terrible. My funny suit. It is a terrible. It's a terrible problem. Because yesterday I left them on the straw bale, and because I left them on the straw bale, I did not dance today at all, not really at all. And it was like, because I have a purpose. I wake up in the morning, I'd sometime in the day put on the shoes, so I dance there. And if the straw bale only put me into the socks, and dancing in the socks is like not the same at all. So when you have the person, when you have the place, the object, when you have this specific craft or this skill or this dedication moment, and all of a sudden it is available to you. Sometimes it just seems like where you put it in the room, it has a momentum space, energy extra, doesn't it? Seems like it has like a different quintuple type of event, It's just like, I cannot believe how easy, how easy. I just always put them in the same spot, I dance every day. It's as simple as that, and in the years before, I had them in the storage. I put them in one of those storage facilities, and they never were worn. So I only had a few good shoes there, but this point was, they were never worn, and so don't put them in one of those places, because it's not really dance's fault. It's not dance's fault that I have to. Use them as some alter ego of expression of why everything went so abysmal, why it went all so wrong. Was it because I didn't full split my penché? Again and again, I have to live with this. I didn't full split my penché. Is that our only reason? The only reason, really. So I asked the gods. That's the only reason. That's why I was teary-assed. I didn't split my Bonchet. No, actually, the TRS was before. But the Bonchet event. I don't know, you can't split Vivandière. You can attempt to split Vivandière, but I think it's a danger. You have to have like strange legs or something. I don't know who these girls are. They're coming out with the, they can split the Vivandière? Who are these girls? Yeah, and I start to get mad. I get so mad at this whole situation that they could even do such thing. That's my big claim to fame, you know. I couldn't split the Bonchet. So anyway, so here's the shoes, the madness of the shoes. And all the insults, yes, split the Bonchet, you know, that's all they want, you know, this uproar of this obnoxious self, which isn't true, is me, isn't true, is me, isn't it? It's because I am this obnoxious self, knowing I'm not splitting my Bonchet. I know it already. They are just a massive reflection of me. My own critique. Oh, watch out, there's some other dancers. I don't want to dancer anymore. Yeah, watch that. I can hear them leaving. I can hear them leaving and running off to college. Yeah. No, I don't want to. So when the shoes are here, back to this type of matter, this holdent matter, this space energy, and the keepage in the brain, you know, how dedicated my thoughts become to it. You know, how it becomes an owner of my brain thought, momentum, of even my physical occurrence of what I'm going to do in an exercise. It's incredible. It's just incredible. So yeah, I have to have them out, I have to have them exposed, I have to have them out. Even if, to just give me that, what do you call it, that, the shaming of, you know, shame on you, you didn't dance in me today. So, if the shoes could talk. Why do I let the day go off on a grudge and not? I don't know, because I feel unhappy that I let the day miss. I've always hated it, like the Sunday time frame. Like, what is Sunday all about? You know, there's a day off and there's no dancing and there's no performance in the company, and there's a Sunday and there's nothing going on. It's like the worst day for me ever as a dancer. I cannot believe. I still cannot believe I stopped dancing on the real professional level. I still can't believe it. So there they are then. So they're calling me now. So I imagine this is what I'm speaking is the same as anybody who has a skill or a task or some medium of expressionism where they are great at, where they're tapestried. They can weave beautiful tapestries. You know, this type of event, you know, maybe that is a fortune. And then they just, oh, I left it. But maybe they just tuck it away somewhere, and they get fulfilled in other things, just the news on the radio or on the television, or the over here on the internet fighting with some persons. But it's just like, maybe bring the tapestry out again, you know. Maybe just bring it out and have little moments there. It is an incredible uplift in a personal space, in a personal space where you were once already accomplished, to try and re-begin your accomplishment again. It is a wonderful space in your esteem entry, your self-esteem. You'll find actually, even in leaving, how much extra self-esteem goes also. It's just like incredible. But you find, oh my gosh, I have a specialty. And even if your specialty is something you have to go back when you were 8 or 9 years old, you were phenomenal at something. phenomenal. Maybe you just made those like pogo stick things around in the park. Maybe that's all you did, but you knew how to make them flip 3 or 4 times. You know, maybe that is your energy, and you are our circus special. You know, that is something I can do. I cannot do this. So I think this is what's happened with much of this over honing in to these day jobs, and then you go off into the televisions. And you go off into your regular life, and the day jobs, and then you go off into the televisions. All of these skills that you once did and you were in doing before, whether it's a ridiculous of juggle or something, all of these skills that you're doing before, and you lose them, it's just an empty heart, missed. Because there was a freedom there, wasn't there? There was a freedom of expression. That in your accomplishment, that you're just a proud momentumist, and that concentration self. It's not something that the persons can take away from you. You know, it seems like much of the other persons want to take away your energy. And that becomes a fight, doesn't it? It's like, don't take away my energy, you know, don't take away my energy, make me listen to this over there, make me listen to that over there, busy me over in this direction, busy me in that direction. Just maybe don't try so much on the energy of the take. Just don't try so much on the energy of the taking. I don't know, it seems the world control freaks. I might take you. And the world control freaks, they want to overtake, don't they? You know, in a manipulative fashion. Pull your string over here, pull your string over there. My puppet master is like we're fighting. I'm the puppet master, or you're the puppet master, you know. All these people are trying to fight who's the puppet master. I don't want to be a puppet master at all. But sometimes persons need a puppet master. They need a leader. But they don't want their strings pulled inordinately, as past governmentships of the world have done. They have overpulled and yanked and hurt persons by their invasive procedures. So I'm going to, oh my gosh, yeah, I guess that was enough for this video today. This is really what I was trying to speak of, was if you have this momentum device that gives you a special place of energy, try to keep a harbor of where it is, keep a location of where it is, you know, don't hide it away. And tap into your skills again, you know, whatever it is. Tap into that skill again. All right, and that is also something we always use, you know. Any government downfall or collapse, we always have, you know, we always have that, quiet place, and that it is a professionalism. It is a professionalism. So, all right.